Let us all be seated. We'd like to welcome everyone to our first Lunch and Learn series this year. Today's session is entitled, Your Faith Sounds Familiar. What a way to start a new year, right? We're blessed to have with us Brother George Gabriel, one of the most charismatic Catholic lay preachers to discuss the seemingly unfathomable but extremely relevant topic of faith. Our brother George Tolentino Gabriel has been passionately serving the Lord for more than 2 decades. Over the years, he has developed himself as a resource speaker, host, singer, team-building facilitator, retreat master, and event director. He is currently the creative director of Shepherd's Voice Radio and TV Foundation, the media office that produces all the TV, radio, and internet programs of Bo Sanchez. He's also the editor-in-chief of Fish, the award-winning inspirational youth magazine under Shepherd's Voice publication. He's the author of 2 books, Love Life and Live Life, A Call to Experience Each Day to the Full. Copies are also available outside if you're interested to buy. His other roles as a full-time servant of the Light of Jesus family include worship director, kerygma preacher, feast builder, and program director for its major events such as the annual Kerygma Conference with a peak attendance of 20,000. He regularly preaches with Bo Sanchez at the Feast and PICC Plenary Hall every Sunday at 1 p.m. He also appears occasionally on the daily internet program, Preacher in Blue Jeans. Our brother George here finds much fulfillment in bringing out the best in others, especially when it comes to getting their message across. He's a mentor to the worship leaders and young preachers of the Light of Jesus family, and recently established SPEAK, which stands for Stage Proficiency, Eloquence, and Kinesthesia, an online one-on-one coaching program for public speaking. Ultimately, George believes that the gospel of Christ is best shared by loving others as Jesus did. His greatest calling is to be a faithful husband to his wife, Dina, a loving father to his 7-month-old son, Anton. Let us all welcome in ADB our brother George Gabriel.
Good morning. Good afternoon na pala. That is a sales parating good morning, di ba? So why don't you tell the person beside you anyway, good morning pa rin. Thank you so much for that lovely introduction which sinulat ng nanay ko. And I'm so honored to be here with you today, Sister Elvie. Thank you for inviting me. And I'm excited to share God's word with you because I'm excited for 2016. How many of you had a good 2015? Raise your hand. Good 2015. Sige, pakibaba ang kamay. How many of you had a not so good 2015? Meron ba? Tingin na agad. Siyempre, wala nga amin, di ba? How many of you believe that 2016 will be even better than 2015? Yes. Konting energy naman. If you believe it, make some noise. Okay. Pakisabi sa katabi mo, you will have a better year this year. Amen. Hallelujah. Your faith sounds familiar, right? I do you watch this show? Yes? Aminin, ha? Sino nanonood nitong kantang to, ha? Alright, nitong show na to. Pakitaas ang kamay? Okay. Dun sa mga hindi umamin, i-explain natin. Alright, this is a lip-sync show, alright? This is a show where people dress up and you know, pretend to be someone else. And, you know, they try to imitate yung mga idol nila. And I nakukyutan ako sa concept, sabi ni Sister Elvie, okay lang ba neto yung title? I'm like, wow, it's a very creative title because the reality is, alright, the reality is that sometimes, pakisabi sometimes, sometimes yung faith natin, linilip-sync lang natin. Gets niyo ba yun? Tama ba? Or kung hindi man lip-sync, sometimes yung faith natin, naaarte lang natin, pero sa loob, hindi naman talaga ganun. Sometimes we pretend. Sometimes we put on a show. Sometimes it's not real. And sometimes we forget what it is to be a Christian, all right? That's why I want to talk about deja vu. Do you know what deja vu is? Sino rito ang na-deja vu na? Huh? Pakikwento naman, okay lang ba? I'll give you 1 minute. 1 minute lang. Ikwento mo sa katabi mo, isang instance lang na nag-deja vu ka. Yung parang, alam niyo yung deja vu, no? Yung parang, oh, parang nangyari na to dati sa akin. Ha? Okay lang ba? 1 minute lang. Ready, get set, go. Kwento sa katabi mo. Kwento lang sa katabi mo. Na-deja vu ka na ba before? Ano yung nangyari? Ano yung nakita mo? Sige na, kwento na mo yung katabi mo. Para lang makita natin na talagang nangyayari ito sa buhay natin. Yung girlfriend ko nung college, meron siyang dream boy. Hindi ako. Okay? Dream boy, bakit? Kasi sabi niya, nung nakita niya tong lalaking dumaan, first time daw niyang nakita, it was her first time to see this guy, sabi niya, I have dreamt about this guy before. Nakita na raw niya sa panaginip niya, pero first time niya nakita after niyang mapanaginipan. Naniniwala ba kayo sa ganon? Posible ba yon na napanaginipan niya, pero hindi pa niya nakikita? Posible ba yon? Do you think so? Because scientists will argue that deja vu actually is a trick of the mind. Because 10% of your mind is conscious and 90% of your mind is unconscious, all right? Yung 10%, yan yung ginagamit ninyo every day to ano, to think, to make decisions, pero yung 90%, diyan na pupunta yung memories ninyo. Diyan na pupunta yung mga bagay na ginagawa nyo over and over again, then they become habit. Sino nag-toothbrush kaninang umaga? Pakitaas ang kamay. Okay, baka nakalimutan na ninyo. Sobrang sanay na. Did anyone wake up this morning and ask yourself, mag-toothbrush pa kaya ako? Anong araw ba ngayon? Monday ngayon, may meeting. Kailangan ko magsipilyo. Diba? Hindi nyo na iniisip yon. Wala na sa 10% yon. It's in the 90%. Why? Because it's a habit. Say habit. But there's other things that also go into 90%, and those are also your long-term memories. The things that you saw, tapos nabaon na sa utak mo. Ganun ang paniniwala ko, hindi ako papayag na iba yung dream boy ng girlfriend ko noon. Nakita na yung guy na yon, dumaan na yon, hindi niya tinitigan, but she saw him. And somehow, it got stored into her mind. She wasn't aware of it. But it went into her unconscious mind. And maybe when she was asleep, scientists say when you're asleep, your brain processes everything that you saw. Yung mga langaw na nakita nyo today, pinaprocess ng utak nyo yan. Okay? Yung mga pinagkwekwentuhan ng mga kasama mo o kaya yung mga nandyan sa paligid mo in your cubicles, kahit hindi ka nakikinig, somehow pumapasok sa utak mo yan. When you're asleep, lalaman mo yan, maaalala mo. Sometimes the brain will select what to bring out and surface to your conscious mind. But the point is, you remember everything. Everything gets stored into your mind. Tell someone beside you, everything is stored in your mind. What's the problem? Ask me, what's the problem? The problem is, we don't remember everything. It's there, pero hindi natin naaalala lahat. Naaalala lang natin minsan, baka pag kailangan natin, o kaya pag may connection. And I remember Mike Joseph. Mike Joseph is the man who started the charismatic renewal in the Philippines with the Ligaya ng Panginoon community. He is the mentor of Bo Sanchez. And I have the privilege of sharing, you know, discussions with him every other week nung magkasama kami sa small group. And I remember Mike used to say, you know what, a certain saint said, lahat naman tayo mabait, minsan nakakalimutan lang natin. Agree ba kayo ron? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, mabait ka naman eh. Sabi mo sa kanya, mabait ka naman. Ulyanin lang. Tama ba? We are good people. We are good people deep within. The problem is sometimes we forget that we are loved by God. We forget that there is goodness in us. In the moment of, gusto mong manakal at manigaw, nakakalimutan mo, oops, teka, hindi pala ako yan. Nakakawala yung nasa loob ko. I forget the goodness in me. Such an example is a guy named Zacchaeus. Say Zacchaeus. Can you read this story with me all together? Okay lang, from Luke 19, 1 to 4. All together, out loud. Ready, get set, go! In the Bible, some theologians say Zacchaeus was made to be small to represent the smallness of his spirit or his spirituality. Hindi niya makita si Lord kasi nga maliit. Continue all together. When Jesus came to that place, "Hurry down, Zacchaeus, because I must stay in your house today." All the people who saw it started grumbling, "This man has gone to a guest of a home of a sinner." Pinag-usapan nila si Kristo, bakit daw si Kristo pumunta kay Zacchaeus? Eh, makasalanan yun. And this is the exciting part, right? This is the exciting part, right? Read it a little louder. Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Listen, sir, I will give half of my belongings to the poor, and I will pay 4 times as much." Anong nangyari dito? There is a Tagalog word for what happened here. Siya ay nagbalik loob. He turned around. He changed his ways. He made a decision to live a different life henceforth. And this is, alam nyo, maraming beses na natin nabasa to. Tama ba? We've read this so many times. But when I came upon this passage one day, the Lord spoke to me so powerfully in the last few lines. Please read them together. Jesus said to him, "Salvation has come to this house today, for this man also is a descendant of Abraham. The Son of Man came to seek and save the lost." What is the root word of salvation? Salvage, alright? Tama ba? Or save, tama ba? Alright, what is your name, ma'am?
Evangeline.
Evangeline, ano po ang pangalan ng tatay ninyo?
Policarpo.
Policarpio. Po, poli, kakaiba, no? Policarpo lang. Policarpo, kailan mo patatay si Policarpo?
Since birth,
okay? Andito si Angeline? Evangeline, anak ni Policarpo. Ngayon ko lang sinabi. Ngayon nyo lang nalaman na anak siya ni Policarpo. Pero agree ba kayo na dati pa siya anak ni Policarpo? Yes or no?
Yes.
Because salvation means to save something. But here's the thing, alright? Think about this. Huwag nyo kalimutan yung example ko kay Miss Evangeline. If you type out a document in the computer, anong tatanong, di ba? Tatanong parate, do you want to save changes you made? Or do you want to save this document? Kung ganyan ang itsura ng document nyo, isa-save nyo pa ba yan? Yes or no?
No.
No. Bakit? There's nothing to save. Walang laman. But if there's, let's say, a password, or kahit dalawang letra lang na mahalaga para sa'yo o may ibig sabihin sa'yo, isa-save mo yan, tama ba? Yes, because you cannot save something that does not belong to you. You cannot lose something that does not belong to you. Agree? Jesus said, "Salvation has come to this house today." In other words, this man was saved today. But look, huh? For this man also is a descendant of Abraham. Kailan naging descendant ni Abraham si Zacchaeus? Nung nagbalik loob siya o dati pa? Dati pa. He's always been a descendant of Abraham. He has always been God's possession. Kaso lang, nalimutan niya, lumihis ng daan. The day that he decided, "Magbabalik loob ako kay Lord," what happened? Siya ay nasagip. He was saved from going away and he came back. The Son of Man came to save and seek the lost, those who are already in God's possession but went astray. If there's nothing to save, you won't save it. But you are being saved by God always. Why? Because you are God's possession. Tell someone beside you, you are God's possession. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Do you agree?
Yes.
Do you agree that we are good people, but sometimes we forget? Yes? Do you agree that your son or your daughter na sobrang pasaway, sakit ng ulo, is a good child, nakakalimutan lang niya, or hindi lang niya naiintindihan siguro yung kabutihan niya? Do you agree that that office mate that is very difficult to get along with is still a good person? Pero baka iba lang yung pagiging mabait niya. Ika nga, lahat tayo anak ng Diyos. Yung iba, hindi lang obvious. Pero anak pa rin ng Diyos yan. And so what I want to share with you today is three things that will keep your faith familiar. Are you interested in these? Alright. Yung mas walang gana pa. Are you interested? Okay. Chine-check ko lang. Okay? Sige. The first is exercise. Everybody say exercise. Everybody stand up. Everybody stand up. 10 jumping jacks. Ready, get set. Seryoso ako. Go! 1, 2, 3, 4. Kahit naka-heels. Sige na. 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, yung mga nakatayo, palakpakan nyo yung mga nakaupo pa. Okay? Biro lang. Alright, sit down. Thanks. I just wanted to get that out of the way. You know what? Doctors say that around 3 to 4 times in a day, you need to just get up and do a few jumping jacks. You need to get up and walk around the office. Why? Because when you're sitting at a desk the whole day, naniligas yung mga muscle ninyo. And faith is a muscle. Faith is a muscle. Tell someone beside you, faith is a muscle. And what you do not exercise, what you do not use, you lose. What you do not use becomes useless. Etong tuhod ko, may problema. I had an MRI recently and nakita ko that there's thinning of the cartilage, yung muscle na umahawak dun sa patella, medyo numipis na. And because of that, it's very painful for me to jump. Pero naki-jumping jacks pa rin ako. And I don't know if Sister LV notices this. Ngayon ko lang i-share to, pero sa feast, I'm one of the worship leaders of Bo Sanchez. I'm also a co-preacher. Pero ako pag nag-lead ako ng worship, I'm all over the stage. Parang party talaga. But recently, hindi pa naman ako na-assign. Pero yung times na nasa stage ako, lumulundag ako ganito. Kasi masakit talaga. It's very painful. I have a hard time going up and downstairs. And so now I'm in a process of rehabilitation. But even as I'm rehabilitating my knee, I'm also exercising it. I'm still walking every day. Kasi sabi ng doktor, okay lang maglakad ng ganun. Mahirap lang yung paakyat. Mas masakit yung pababa. Pero every day, I've been walking ever since I found out. Because I realized the reason why my knee gave way is because kulang ako sa exercise. Kulang ako sa regular use. E bigla ako nag-basketball. Hataw ako. Right after that, sakit ng tuhod ko. Men, naiintindihan natin yan, di ba? Matagal ka nang di naglaro, biglang maglalaro ka, biglang pulikat, o kaya hinihingal ka. It's really the way it is. If you don't regularly exercise, you will get out of shape. My knee is out of shape now because of lack of use. And so I'm rehabilitating it. I'm walking 1 hour every day while I'm listening to Christian teachings, while I'm listening to different Christian speakers feed me the Word of God. That's what I do. And that's why I believe that as I strengthen my knee, one day, makakapagtalon ulit ako. I'm gonna be able to play basketball again. I will get back into shape. Question, kamusta ang status ng faith mo? Have you been exercising your faith? What does it mean to exercise your faith? You know what? No one gets thin by sitting down. The reason why it's hard to do is because you have to get up. It's uncomfortable. It takes effort. Tama ba? By just sitting in mass every week and not doing anything about what you hear, your faith doesn't get into shape. It's not good enough to hear the Word of God. It's the first step. But remember, Jesus said, "He who hears and obeys my word, those are the people that are truly blessed." You gotta do something about what you hear. Today, you're hearing a message. My prayer is that more than whatever I say now, but you're able to put it into action after. You read something great, apply it right away. And beyond, all right, going to Mass once a week is like, you know, it's like going to the gym once a week or maybe going to the gym once a month in terms of your spirit. Why? Because your spirit needs to be worked out every single day. What you want to do is after Mass, continue reading, continue listening, continue watching videos, continue buying books, continue talking to people in the same faith, continue attending prayer meetings, continue worshiping, continue listening to music and singing along with it. You understand what I'm saying? You need to exercise your faith. You need to talk about your faith. Because when you talk about your faith with people, tatanong ka nila, talaga bang naniniwala ka dyan sa sinasabi mo? Then you have to think about it. And then your faith is strengthened. You need to learn to defend your faith. You need to learn to share your faith. Anything that is action-oriented will exercise your faith. How many of you think your faith needs to be exercised just a little bit more? Raise your hand. Come on. Amen. Pakitapik yung katabi mo, tignan mo siya, sabihin mo, exercise your faith. Hawakan mo yung kamay ng katabi mo. Sige na, hawakan mo yung kamay. Tignan mo sa mata, please. Tignan mo sa mata. Come on, do it. Sabihin mo sa kanya, yung faith mo. Sabihin yung mas malakas, yung faith mo. I-zumba mo na. Amen? Ang lakas natin mag-zumba. Pero hindi natin sinuzumba yung faith natin. Pumapayat nga kayo sa katawan nyo, pero yung faith nyo malnourished. You gotta get your faith into shape. Amen? Palakpakan natin si Lord. Amen. The second way to exercise or to get your faith familiar is through experience. Say experience. When I talk about experience, I mean the world teaches you. The world shapes you up. Life trains you. Tama ba? Hindi pwedeng aral lang ng aral yung bata sa school. Hindi lang pwedeng knowledge lahat. He has to go out into the world and allow defeat, hurt, di ba? Pain. I'm looking at my 7-month-old son now and iniisip ko, grabe, sana hindi ma-heartbroken yung anak ko one day. We wanna have a daughter soon. And I keep thinking, naku, pag may lalaking, saktan yung anak ko, grabe. But is it realistic? Can we keep ourselves from being hurt? Is it possible to really shelter the people we love? Hindi, di ba? Pero meron akong request. Pakikurot lang yung katabi mo. Sige na, kurot mo lang. Okay. Buhay pa ba yan? Hindi, buhay pa ba siya? That person is here. What does that mean? That all the trials in your life, lahat ng mga pagsusubok ninyo, the financial, the physical, the relational, the emotional, the spiritual, all your problems, all your trials, none of them defeated you. Why? You're still here. Humihinga ka pa ba? Pakinggan mo nga, humihinga pa ba yung katabi mo? The fact that that person is alive means your trials did not kill you. They strengthened you. They strengthened you. Are you not stronger now because of your trials? Yes? Are you not wiser now because of your trials? Yes? 1 Corinthians 10:13, one of my absolute favorite verses. Read it together. Every test that you have experienced is the kind that normally comes to people. But God keeps His promise and He will not allow you to be tested beyond your power to remain firm. At the time you are put to the test, He will give you the strength to endure it and so provide you with a way out. Mga kapatid, hindi sinabi ni San Pablo, God will give you a little strength. He didn't say God will give you some strength. He didn't even say God will give you almost enough strength. What did He say? He said He will give you the strength. When you say the strength, it is commensurate. Tapat. Equal to the task at hand. He gives you the strength to handle bigger challenges. Tomorrow, may mas malaki kang pagsusubok. Kasi nag-graduate ka na today, tama ba? When your bigger trial comes tomorrow, mas malaking strength yung makukuha mo. Life, experiences, pain, failure, defeat, disappointment, rejection, all of these things, loss, death, heartbreak, betrayal, all of these things teach us to trust God more. Because when everything is happy-happy, hindi naman kailangan ng faith eh. Tama ba? Kung kailangan ng faith, laki ng kinikita ko, ganang kotse ko, everything is going fine. Thank you, Lord. Pero hindi kailangan ng faith. Pero pag iniwanan ka na nung minamahal mo, when you lose your job, when someone close to you gets hurt or goes astray, and you want to control it, that's when you need faith. That's when you say, Lord, grabe, parang di ko kaya to. But I will choose to trust. This trial, hindi ako matatalo. It will strengthen my faith. Just like before. Because God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He brought you through your trials before. He will bring you through your trials in 2016. Amen? Apir naman sa katabi mo, sabihin mo, you're gonna make it. Amen. Palakpakan natin si Lord. You need to learn from your experiences. Learn from your experiences. Ang experience, mabuti o masama, it doesn't matter. What's important is you learn. It's okay to fail. But if you didn't learn, sayang. But if you learned, it becomes very valuable. Amen? Amen. The third is example. Say example. So we learn or we familiarize or keep our faith fresh through exercising it, through experiencing trials and tribulations, and also by following examples. Kilala niyo ba tong lalaking to? Sino yan? Si Gary V. 6 years old pa lang ako, sobrang idol ko na si Gary V. What more can I say? You're going away this time for real. Now who's to blame? Is it you? Is it me? Is it right for him? Babs ako. Pero kaboses ko pa rin siya alam ko. Kasi bata pa lang ako, ginagaya ko na siya. Ginagaya ko lahat ng galaw niya. Pero hindi ako ganun kagaling sumayaw. Pero lahat ng kulot ng kanta niya, lahat ng album niya, meron ako. I've been following him. Naku, lalo na nung naging Kristiyano siya. Sobrang akong, yes, yung idol ko, God lover din. Because I became a Christian, I received Jesus in my life as a Catholic charismatic when I was 12 years old. And so when Gary V turned Christian, parang, oh man, sobrang idol ko talaga. I've been following him all my life. The way he talks, the way he performs and everything. And super idol. This picture was taken 3 years ago. And many, many years ago, nakilala ko na siya. In fact, I was backstage with him. Ako yung assistant niya. Pero hindi niya ako naaalala. Nakita ko ulit sa restaurant. Nagpakilala na naman ako. Oh, do you remember me? Siyempre, sabihin niya, yes, that was you. Pero malamang, di na naman niya ako maaalala. But this night, nanood kami ng play, nakita ko siya sa lobby. Ah, sabi ko, eto na talaga. Talagang itatatak ko na yung mukha ko sa alaala ni Gary V, alright? And I went up to him and I really said, "Hi Gary, how are you?" And I don't know if you remember once before, kwento siya. "Yes, that was you!" Eh, di ganun ulit, di ba? Pero ngayon, talagang sinigurado ko, you know, I work with Bo Sanchez, we have a Kerygma conference, are you available to be a speaker or performer? Eh, nagkataon mahaba yung oras niya. So talagang 10 minutes kami nagkwentuhan. Can you imagine? 10 minutes with your idol. And so may mga taong lumalapit para mag-autograph ako. "Mamaya na kayo, di ba? Kami muna." And after that, eto na. Para siguradong maalala niya ako, kapal na mukha, kinuha ko yung number niya. Alright? I got his number. Kasi sabi ko, let's coordinate about Kerygma conference. Text ako nung gabi. Siyempre, huwag masyadong maaga. Parang hindi masyadong fan, di ba? Parang the next day na lang, di ba? "Hi Gary, great to meet you." Nag-reply ang Gary V. Talagang, alam mo, ibebenta ko 1 million tong telepono ko, ha? Kasi nandito si Gary V sa phone ko. Reply siya, "It was great to meet you again, George. I'll check my calendar." Long story short, hindi siya naging available, pero one day, pagbukas ko ng telepono ko, eto yung text ko. Talagang pinakita ko sa inyo, ha? Baka kasi hindi kayo naniniwala. Eto pa. So, ayan ha. Sabi niya, "I cannot go." Sabi niya, "I can't attend, but please invite me. K?" Si Gary V, nagki-K, okay? So ako naman, "Music to our ears. Thanks, Gary. Please pray for the conference. We hit our targets in terms of tickets. Now it's more creatives. Gotta make everything reach in time. Anything you need prayers for?" Magpadasal sa akin si Gary V. "Tignan nyo naman. I have a session in the studio today for a theme song for UNICEF, which I perform on Thursday. George, I'd appreciate a prayer for sustained strength and passion for the gift and calling I have." George said my name. God. So ako ngayon, FC na ka ako kay Gary V. Alam niyo, FC? Feeling close, okay? Feeling close na ako kay Gary V. So talagang pinagyabang ko to sa pamilya ko. Ganyan sila parang, "Oh my God! Kilala ka ni Gary V!" Pero syempre sabi ko, malamang baka hindi niya ako maalala. Eh, kasi nag-know na siya sa conference. Malay ko ba kung magte-text siya ulit? One day, eto ang nangyari. Hindi akong nagsimula. Siya ang nag-initiate ng conversation, okay? Hindi siya nag-asap. Break sila sa asap. Napanood niya ako sa TV. Si Gary, ako yung napanood sa TV, okay? Baliktad na, alright? At tinext niya ako, sabi niya, "George, I'm watching you now. Your message is anointed," kasi nagsub ako for Bo Sanchez. Yun yung kaisa-isang time na nag-absent si Bo, ako nag-sub. Napanood niya, okay? Talagang the stars aligned for my favor. Speaking, God, nag-minister yung preaching ko kay Gary V. Oh my God, man, idol ko to, di ba? Sabi ko, "Hey, cool." Siyempre ako, hindi niya nakita, nag-freak out muna ako, di ba? Pero, "Hey, cool." Ganun lang ako, di ba? Para hindi halata. "Hey, cool. Thanks, bro. Praise God for His word. How's your trip? God bless you in ASAP. Oh, today's a break. They're showing LA. I leave for Singapore." Talaga, alam ko rin itinerary niya, di ba? I mean, I'm having fun, too much fun with this point. Just to let you know that, I mean, it's a thrill when you get to meet your hero. When you get to really follow someone's example. Pero, inasmuch as sobrang fanboy ako, hindi naman ako baliw. Alam ko naman na hindi ako imbitahin ni Gary sa birthday niya. Alam ko naman yon, alright? Hindi naman ako ganun ka-FC, okay? And so, at least now, medyo may konting communication, but I still may not learn of his personal life. You know, I may not learn about how what he thinks, what he goes through with his children, because we're not really that close. Unlike this person, who's another hero of mine. I've idolized this guy since I was 17 years old. Read his books, wanted to speak like him. Man, I cannot imagine the goodness of God, one day, He allowed me to walk into their office. They needed a volunteer writer. Available ako. Then one thing led to another. I started helping out, volunteering. One day napansin niya ako. Siyempre, kasi panay ang lapit ko sa kanya at magkakamay ako. And eventually, he hired me. And he hired me to be part of his company, his organization. But not only that, he brought me into his small circle. Meron kaming small sharing group. Yung idol ko, nagdi-dinner sa bahay ko once a month. Parang ako talaga, every time mangyari yun, selfie, okay? Evidence, di ba? Parang, but this was 8 years ago. Today, I'm just more honored to be called his friend, okay? I still follow him. I still look to him as an example. Pero ang hindi ko alam is, idol din pala niya ako. Ginagaya niya ako magbihis, okay? Biro lang. But seriously, this man is a great example to me. Because I've discovered that aside from him being a great preacher, a great storyteller, he is a genuine person. I've been with him on several out-of-town trips. Sometimes I'm the cameraman. Nung early days pa, ako yung cameraman niya. Okay? It was part of my job. There was one time, kinailangan ko gumamit ng internet sa kwarto niya. And I saw him in his pajamas, white t-shirt, tulog na yung pamilya niya. And I just said, wow, nandito ko sa loob ng kwarto ni Bo Sanchez. But then, I did that once or twice and I saw that the way he talks to his wife, the way he talks to his kids, man, this person is the same person you see on stage and off stage. He's genuine, he's real. And that's what inspires me the most. Ibang usapan kapag talagang kilala mo na yung tao. It makes so much impact in your life as an example. But the greatest example of faith I've ever had is that of my father's. My father was, you know, a great man. He dedicated his whole life to community. He is the one who introduced me to Jesus when I was 12 years old, brought me into a life of service. Today, I'm serving still because of him. And I've always wanted to be like my dad. I've always wanted to, when I was young, pareho yung jacket namin, nagpa-vitalis din ako, pareho yung sa yung hiwa ng buhok namin, kung paano siya gumalaw, or athlete siya, gusto ko rin maging ganon. And I can't tell you about him today, there's too much to say. So pakibasa na lang yung libro ko, for sale outside. Galing, di ba? Ganyan ang marketing, alright? I've written about him in my books, Live Life and Love Life, and they're also e-books, you can catch them online. But seriously, this is the reason why I feel so proud to be my father's son. Ask me why. Because the example he set for all of us was not about himself. He pointed all of us to Jesus. You know what? When you're an example to someone, yes, it's about your action sometimes, but there's even greater purpose to being an example when you're also following someone else's example, a greater person's example. And I believe that Gary V, Bo Sanchez, Jun Gabriel, all of them are great examples to me. Because they follow the example of Christ. Because of them, I want to be more Christ-like. Do you have good examples in your life? Are you surrounded by people who model the faith to you? Do you watch them on TV? Do you have coffee with them? Are they in your immediate circle? Maybe they're not. This year, my invitation for you is, follow good examples. Deliberately go after mentoring. Deliberately say to yourself, I want to improve my faith. And so I need more role models. If you ask God for them, God will give them to you. Tell someone beside you, follow good examples. Palakpak natin si Lord. So what's the first thing you do? Exercise. Then experience. Then examples. Can I close with a story? Is this okay? This is how my son Anton looked when he was first born. This was the first day of Anton. And everyone, even my family said that my son looked like my wife. Okay? If you see my wife, talagang kamukha niya yan. Actually, I found a baby picture of my wife when she was newborn at natakot ako. Akala ko anak ko yung asawa ko. Okay? Seryoso. So everyone said, wow, chikyam kong chikyam ko. Chikyam, kamukha ni Dinah. Tapos lahat ng mga tao sinasabi nila, sorry George, kamukha ni Dinah. Ako naman ang sagot ko, okay lang, bago pa yan. Diba? Ganun ang baby, diba? Nagbabago yan, diba? But seriously, I mean, it's fine with me. I wasn't sensitive about it, seriously. And so as our son grew, we would train him to do all sorts of things. Magbasa, galing, magluto, okay? So kung ano-ano pinapa, magmodel, tinuturuan namin yan, okay? Pero naisip ko nga, parang oo nga naman, lalaki yan. Kailangan maging, di ba? Katulad ko. So I decided to spend more and more time with my son. When he was younger, this was probably in his first month, alright? And because I kept spending time with him, talking to him, you know, babies, they love being talked to. Hindi kanila naiintindihan, pero gusto lang nila yung kinakausap mo, sumasagot sila. Sa kakaganong ko, eventually na-realize ko, napansin ko, parang ginagaya na niya ako. Parang yung mga galaw ko, ginagaya niya kahit matulog, pareho kami, ng kamay, tignan niyo. Diba? Hindi unscripted ah, totoo yan. And so all the more I realized, wow, ang sarap for you know my son to follow me. So I continue spending time with him, teaching him things. I'm a drummer. We bring him to kinder music, so you know he loves the drums. Also, he has rhythm in him. All of these things happen. Pero syempre, yung side ng asawa ko hanggang ngayon, chikyam ko kamukha ni Dinah, kasi dun sila familiar eh. Tama ba? It makes total sense. Paminsan, yung family ko, ayan na, nagiging kamukha mo na. Di ba? Okay lang, yes, sige, hindi pa final. Everyone wants to see what they want to see. My life changed when he was 6 months old and my wife sent me this picture. Ako yan, kung hindi nyo pa nagigets, ha? Okay? Both at 6 months old. This is me at 6 months. That is my son at 6 months. Tanong, kamukha ko ba ang anak ko? It's settled. Yung talaga sinabi ko sa Facebook, it's settled, folks. Hey, magbabago ulit yung mukha ng anak ko. Tama? For all I know, he'll grow up to be like my wife, look like my wife. That's fine with me. Kaya ako nga siya pinakasalan eh, kasi maganda siya, okay? I don't mind. But this picture will forever remind me, once upon a time, I was reminded by God, George, you look like your son. And George, you look like me. You will always look like your Heavenly Father. No matter what other people say about you, no matter what names other people call you, no matter how you see yourself, at sa tingin mo lumayo ka na kay Lord, or the people around you, feeling nyo hindi nila kamukha si Lord, I gotta tell you this, brothers and sisters, sa mata ni Lord, tayo forever kamukha niya. Nothing can change that. Nothing can take that away. Because all of us are descendants of Abraham. All of us are children of our Heavenly Father. Amen? Amen. Palakpakan natin si Lord. At pakisabi sa katabi mo, kamukha ka ni Lord. Amen? One last thing I want to say, bonus message, another thing that this picture taught me. Have you ever heard a father or one of your fathers say, "Anak, wag mo akong gayahin"? Have you ever heard that before? Habang may hawak siyang yosi, "Anak, wag mo akong gayahin. Masama to." Diba? Habang kumakain siya, diba? Laki ng tiyan niya. "Anak, wag mo akong gayahin. You have to eat right." My father was a very spiritual man. Pero marami rin siyang bisyo. I mean, he couldn't give up smoking. Ang sarap magluto ng pamilya nila. His health was very poor. And so he would tell me sometimes, "Anak, huwag mo akong gayahin." Ang problema nun, idol ko yung tatay ko. And so honestly, I don't smoke, I don't drink. Pero medyo nagaya ko siya sa eating habits growing up. And that's why I'm not in the best health either. That's why I have to try and enforce myself to get healthy. But doesn't every son want to be like their father? Yes or no? Hindi ba lahat naman ng anak ginagaya nila yung magulang nila? Final message. When I saw this picture, I remembered that. I remembered all the fathers who say, "Anak, wag mo kong gayahin." And I made a promise to myself on the day that I saw this. This is what I said. "Lord, ngayon pa lang, habang wala pang malay yung anak ko, I am going to be the best son, the best brother, the best husband, the best friend, the best father that I can be. So that hindi ko sasabihin sa anak kong huwag mo akong gayahin. But when he says, gusto ko maging katulad ng tatay ko, because I do my best, even if I fail sometimes, but I do my best, be like Jesus, my son will learn to be like Jesus." Amen? You are here today. But there are many people who are not here today. Sometimes they cannot look to God right away. They need examples. My encouragement to all of you, be an example of faith. When they look at you, because they are children of God, maybe they've forgotten, they will look at you and say, something is familiar about you. Your faith sounds familiar because I have it in me too. Kaso, nakalimutan ko na. Thank you for reminding me what it means to love the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Tell someone beside you, be an example. Praise the Lord. Palakpakan natin yung Panginoon. Nakalimutan ko, meron pa pala akong isang PS. This is New York. I'm an American citizen. I was born in New York. And I just found out the other day that my son is an automatic American citizen. Pero, posible na pagdating niya ng 18 or 21, kailangan niyang to solidify. I am an American. Or, ayoko maging Amerikano. But he has to choose. But as of today, he's already an American. You're a Christian. You have God's love in your heart. But every day, you need to choose. You need to choose to live your faith every day. Amen? Amen. I think we're out of time, no? Tama? It's 1 o'clock. But can you just take a picture of this or write these down? Okay lang. And then maybe the next time you get together, you can do some sharing, or maybe you can share with a partner. Reflection and sharing. Recall a faith-strengthening experience, something that strengthened your faith in the past year. Number two, whose example of faith do you follow? Meron ba kayong sinusundan? Is there someone who mentors you? Is there someone you try to copy or emulate? Someone who shows you what it means to be like Jesus? Next is, who is looking to you? as an example? Is it your child? Is it your community members, your office mate, your driver, your household help, your boss, your spouse, your siblings? And then last is, I'm going to invite you to make a commitment this year. Okay lang? I mean a commitment. When I say a commitment, kailangan nakasulat, and it's something you will actually schedule. What activity or what new, everybody say new, what new thing will you do this year to exercise your faith? Are you going to wake up 1 hour earlier every day to read the Bible? Are you going to set aside 30 minutes every day to watch an inspirational program online? Are you going to go to Mass an extra day within the week? Are you going to start attending that prayer meeting that that person's been inviting you to for a long time? Are you going to start listening to more Christian music while you're cooking breakfast or while you're on your way home in the car? What concrete thing can you do this year that will exercise your faith more? Amen? Amen. Thank you so much for having me, brothers and sisters. God bless you.
Thank you, Brother George, for this life-giving talk. I think we have a brief time.
It's a virtual coaching program, but it's for people who also don't have time to meet up in person. So the mechanics are on the website, and just check it out if you or anyone you know you think would be interested. Last.